So one of my accessory pieces in the winter garden is a letterbox. Now, you know, with the emails and everything else going on, you know, it's nice to receive still a letter or a card. And so especially in the winter. So I designed this letterbox just to make us realize that when we are in the winter garden or this time, that we do look forward to these handwritten notes and cards that we receive, not just for holidays, but, you know, a birthday or... So the letterbox has become very important. I still cherish the letters and cards I received from my parents who have passed away. And so let me put this together. It's very quick to do. It has, I'm going to put this aside. So you've got a post and a support, and here's the letterbox with the flag and the little opener for the piece, and then a top knot. Now you see I've cut extra pieces. It's because I do like to double up on this just because it's nice to have that dimension. And these letter boxes, it could stand alone or it can be, you know, one that we're going to fill, and that'll be my, let's see, there we go. So I'm going to get some construction glue here. This is, and I've colored my post gray. You know, you can color your post any color you like. I just happen to want it to show up. I'm gonna let that one sit there. I've doubled up on the box, but I'm gonna get to that in a second. So this is the support for it. So I'm gonna add a little bit of glue there. I did not cut double on the flag or the handle or the little top piece that I'll show you. Just on the sides here. Now on the box, so I've colored the opener or the flap and this piece. This has a embossed line. You're going to bend up on it. And it is just simply going to go right on the box like that. So you could have it open if you wanted to. And since I didn't double up on the handle, I'm going to show you. All I did was take some distressed ink. Not the handle, the flap. And I'm just going to go over it with some, so you see that color on the inside when it, if it is open. Now, I didn't have to color that, but I'm just going to go ahead and do it. So that's just a little distressed ink. Now, if you want to leave your flap open, you could put a little piece of red red line tape. I'm just going to have mine kind of half open. And so I'm going to just put a little bit of, well, let's see if this glue there. My glue is being persnickety. So go ahead and just line that up right with the bottom. Oops. Don't worry about if the glue squeezes open. I'm actually going to take and really press down on that so it adheres, and then I bend up on it. Now, I did cut two of these, so now that I've got that piece, I'm going to just put some glue on this second letter box and glue this one on top. I'm going to set that aside a second and just grab some of my gray here. After, if you do double up, you will want to go and add some color along the side, just because, let me bring that in so it's easier, just so you can, you don't see that white. Now, this is going to be a lovely prop for some of your flowers that are in this collection. Or maybe you'll just have it alone. And I'm actually going to go ahead and hit the white line of the, this is the support one. And once your black one or your letterbox, go ahead and hit the edge of that one too. It also gives you a little bit of a shadow underneath. Now it's just time to put it together. So first I'm going to situate my post, and I'm going to put it a little bit up on this card because I do plan on having some flowers at the base of it. So you can take your glue once more. And just go ahead and put some glue on the back. Again, this could be red line tape or double-sided tape, whatever you like to use. And I think I will take my bone folder and just make sure. The glue you use should be able to dry clear, so choose one that will. This is barely art, but it could be anything. Now your support post has a little, that little curved end there is going to situate right around the base or right around one side. And you want to make sure that when you put it on, you can kind of set this in place just for a second. You want to make sure you have some space. So I didn't put any line there, but I can tell you it's, I'm putting it down from the top. Oh, it's about almost 2 3/8 inches. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take and mark a little pencil line there, just a little dot so I know right where it's going to go. And then again, you can put glue on this one. And I find my pencil mark and set it right down there. It looks like it wraps right around that post. And again, if you take your bone folder, you've got white cardstock, you want to make sure you keep everything nice and clean. Good. Okay, now it's time to set your letterbox. And again, it's going to set right along that line. Follow the line there. And you can put some glue on the back of that. This is a little thicker, so I'm going to hold that down. And again, I'm going to go ahead and make sure that fold line is really open. I am going to create it like a little envelope. And you can have it either sticking out this way so people can raise it up, or you can have it actually on top. It doesn't matter. I'll put that on later. Now I'm going to use my little tweezers here to put, this is the little pull on it. And this time I'm going to, since it's such a little piece, is take and just paint some glue on. And put that in place. And this is your post topper. Again, I'm going to just Go ahead and paint some glue on that. And finally, our flag. You can either have it up for, mail is ready to be taken to delivery, or you can have it down. It's up to you. And I'm just going to paint some glue on this. Use my little tweezers here to... And then I'm just going to have mine down a little bit, just like that. And again, I'm going to brush some of these crumbs away. I got a little glue on my, when you're in my studio, you're constantly working around kitty hair. So I'm going to make sure there. There we go. Now I'm going to finish this off with some flowers. Another very fragrant plant that you can, it's actually can be outdoors or indoors, but for the winter months, we tend to bring them inside. So we have this wonderful fragrance from their flowers. That's the jasmine, also known as the star jasmine. And you'll see why when I shape the petals. It's very easy to put together. It does have waxy leaves, so we will use a glaze on them. You'll notice that a lot of plants that don't lose their leaves in the wintertime do have that thicker, waxier, like rhododendron and magnolia, and even the gardenia from the through the Garden Gate collection. So this is like that. So we will put some glaze on the leaves. And you'll see here, I've got, it's a climber, and it'll not only climb up, but it'll flow out. And it's very pretty. We tend to bring these kind of plants indoors or have them indoors and then plant them out later outside just to give us some beauty and also some fragrance during the winter months when we're So closed in. So let's get started. I'm first going to color the leaf, and you'll notice I've got an extra little branch here, and that's to hold some buds. And I'll show you that how easy that is to put together. So they are bright green leaves. So I'm using a nice bright green Copic here. And then I'm gonna go over it with now, you're mostly probably dealing with, you know, white jasmine. I have seen it in a pale pink, but, you know, other than that, that's the colors it comes in. So, but it's very pretty. And like the narcissus, which we also bring indoors or bloom indoors, it has a nice fragrance. Kind of, you know, when you're so closed up at winter with the heat on and everything, makes it nice to, it smells like outdoors. Now, I'm going to color this little branch that holds the buds in the same green. Just set that aside for a second. And you do want to go ahead and shape the leaves before you glaze them. So I'm using my leaf tool. This is from my Tool-in-One. And I'm drawing that distinctive stem line down the center of each leaf. And then go ahead and bend up on it. Now I'm going to take a little bit of pan pastels to shade that. If you don't have the pan pastels, you could also use a bright green dye or ink that would also accentuate that stem line. Now go back, and you are going to add some vein lines. Try not to cross over your stem line. You want to keep that very upright, almost like it's embossed. Makes it very easy with the leaf tool and the leaf pad. Now you can go ahead and give it some shape. I'm going to bend each one of these up. And then I'm also going to take the meeting ball stylus and just soften around that edge a little bit. Just like that. You get these bent up. You can see how distinctive that stem line appears. And if you like, you can kind of put a little scrunch to the tip of these littler leaves just to give them, you know, some dimension, make them look a little more natural. And then finally, I'm going to just draw down the center, just so I could be able to bend it. For the buds here, this bud branch, I am using that medium ball stylus with the bud or the branch facing right side down. And I'm going to take and go back with the little tweezers and bend these so they have some dimension, so they don't look flat. Okay, we'll get ready to glaze. So I glaze with a small brush, and I've just put some out here on a lid, you know, just save these little plastic lids from your food items. And just go ahead and let's glaze this up, make it look waxy. Then I'm going to just set that aside. I'm just going to add a little bit of glaze to the stem and set that aside too. So let's talk about these petals. Why it's called a star jasmine, it's a 5-petal flower. And if I just set that on there like that, you can see it does make a star shape. So I'm going to add a little bit of shading to the center with this bright yellow green and pastel, just to accentuate that. Oh, and while I've got these are the little buds, and you'll see you can do 6. So you can actually, I usually do several of these stems, so you can get, you know, 2 branches at a time out of this. So let's do some shaping. We're going to put, the way this is situated, it looks, these will be your downward petals and these will be your upward petals. So I am going to grab my small loop tool and I'm just going to shape each one of those petals. I'm just flipping it around, have it back upright. And then on these little 2-petal ones, the same thing. Now grab your tweezers. I'm actually going to pinch from the outside here and use my index finger and my thumb to pinch. And then I'm going to work my fingers up and hold that and give it a little pinch on the end. That makes it even more detailed. So again, pinch and then grab the tip, but you've got to hold up close to the tip and bend that tip around the end of the tweezer. And you're going to do this on all the petals. And then you're going to take your small ball stylus and cup it. Now again, on the 2-petal, you're going to do the same thing. So I'm going to pinch around that tip, move it up, move my other hand up, and pinch around that tip. And again, grab your small ball stylus and cup it. Now this time, a lot of times I put the two petal down and then the three. This one's gonna be, you're just gonna put some glue on that two petal. And you know what? I'm gonna switch my pads. I'm gonna use my glued pad. Keep my molding pad a little nicer. And put that right in the center, and then just take your tweezers and hold it down. The Kid's Choice seems to really hold quickly, and as you can see, it makes like a little star. Now for these buds, I'm putting it right side down and using my loop tool to shape. I'm just making it cup up there. And then I'm going to take my small ball stylus to grab it. So you're going to cup each one of these. And each branch will hold three. So we'll put that on next. So let's go ahead and do these buds. So I'm going to put some glue around it. And I've shaped these by bringing it down. So hold it and go ahead and close it around your bud, just like that. Those little calyx will hold that bud nicely. So here we go again. You're going to take and apply some glue. And I'm kind of liberal because I want this to be kind of closed up. And then right into that calyx, grab it. I bring that one up a little bit. There we go. When you've got glue on your fingers, it tends to pull apart. Let's see. Let's go right around that one. Here we go. Now one more. Now the buds are optional, but they are cute to, especially on ones that are climbing like this one. There we go. Now I'm going to set this aside to dry, and we'll start to put ours together. I guess one last thing we should talk about is the stamen. Now, it's kind of a yellowish green. You could certainly cut this out of solid cardstock. I just happen to have a Copic color that's YG00 that has that yellowish green color to it. You don't have to clip into this because it has like little balls on the end of it. But I am going to take and hold on to it, the tail part, and then paint some glue right along that edge. Now roll it up. And you'll notice that middle one is a little taller than the other ones. That's on purpose. If you take and let's separate these so you can see. So you should have four shorter ones. Now what I like to do is use two different. So this one that's longer is typically a bright yellow pollen. So that's what I'm going to bring in here and dip it. The other ones are a little bit toned down. They're not as big as that one. That's the attractor. You know, when a flower has an aroma and this is what attracts the insects to pollinate it. So I've got the, I guess it's called gold, but it looks like an off green. And I'm going to set that aside to dry. So remember our card with the letter box on it. I've already added a few here, and I'm going to go ahead and put a couple of those little flowers right on the branch that I've done here. Let me put one right in there. Like I said, it's a climber. This one that we just did, I'm going to have coming off this way. And again, you could have put, or I could have put, a lot more on here, and maybe, you know, I will finish this off with some more. Because they're fun to make. I mean, they're little flowers. And like I said, they kind of pop these leaves up a bit. Hold down the stem, but give that some shape. And I've added one little stem of buds on this side. I might do one here. I might do one maybe up there. That might be a nice place for it. This would also be pretty with the basket from the holiday collection. Remember, you can always, this would have been pretty, you know, to do some poinsettias and do some jasmine with it in a basket, so. But I thought since we had done the letterbox, this would have been a pretty one to kind of trail down. Add some of these star jasmine I've done. And I've got some little stamens that I can set right in the center. That bright green just looks so Christmassy. So jasmine is a nice one to add to your holiday as well as your winter. I think what I'm going to do is kind of scrunch one up into there too. Our last two stamens. Now let me just get our ladybug done. So I colored the ladybug, and now I'm just using, this is my tried and true art gum eraser that I've done a lot of ladybugs on. And I'm going to add a little bit of glue to one of these leaves. There we go. And then you can also put a little bit of glaze on her. I'm going to test that, make sure not too much is coming out. There we go. You have that really stunning letter box where I've added the wintry wishes coming out of the box there, and you've got your beautiful jasmine. Now you can add some other greenery to it, or I could add some more branches of jasmine, but sometimes simple is just as good. So hopefully you'll love jasmine and you'll add that to your winter garden.